Milkshakers, I'm Naomi and welcome to our first ever Milkshake DVD. Yes, Kemi, Beth and I have been very busy choosing our favourite episodes of our favourite Milkshake programmes so that you can enjoy them too. In this DVD you can jump in some muddy puddles with Pepper and George, you can leap over the funky valley moon with Dippy the cow, catch an enormous fish with Bottle Top Bill and lots more. Oh, and I hope you've been practicing your milkshake shake, because I will be milkshake shaking a bit later on. And the great thing about a DVD is that you can just hit the rewind button and milkshake shake over and over again. So we'd better get started with three programmes. Can you guess what the first one is? That's right, it's Peppa Pig. And after Peppa, we'll catch up with High Five, and then we'll visit the Flower Top Garden with Fifi.
I'm Peppa Pig. This is my little brother, George. This is Mummy Pig. And this is Daddy Pig. Peppa Pig. Muddy puddles.
It is raining today, so Peppa and George cannot play outside.
Daddy, it stopped raining. Can we go out to play?
All right. Run along, you two.
Peppa loves jumping in muddy puddles.
I love muddy puddles.
Peppa? If you jump in muddy puddles, you must wear your boots.
Sorry, Mummy.
George likes to jump in muddy puddles too.
George, if you jump in muddy puddles, you must wear your boots.
Peppa likes to look after her little brother, George.
George, let's find some more puddles.
Peppa and George are having a lot of fun. Peppa has found a little puddle. George has found a big puddle.
Look, George! There's a really big puddle.
George wants to jump into the big puddle first.
Stop, George! I must check if it's safe for you. Good! It is safe for you. Sorry, George. It's only mud.
Peppa and George love jumping in muddy puddles.
Come on, George. Let's go and show Daddy.
Goodness me.
Daddy, Daddy, guess what we've been doing?
Let me think. Have you been watching television?
No, no, Daddy.
Have you just had a bath?
No, no.
I know. You've been jumping in muddy puddles.
Yes, yes, Daddy. We've been jumping in muddy puddles.
Ho, ho. And look at the mess you're in.
Ooh.
Oh, well. It's only mud. Let's clean up quickly before Mummy sees the mess.
Daddy, when we've cleaned up, will you and Mummy come and play too?
Yes, we can all play in the garden.
Peppa and George are wearing their boots. Mummy and Daddy are wearing their boots. Peppa loves jumping up and down in muddy puddles. Everyone loves jumping up and down in muddy puddles.
Oh, Daddy Pig, look at the mess you're in.
It's only mud. Peppa Pig. Peppa Pig. Peppa Pig.
Bye.
I'm Fifi Forget-Me-Not.
Welcome to my garden.
Hello, Fifi! What are you doing?
I'm sticking these canes into the ground beside the plants to help them stand up properly.
I don't need any canes to stand up. I can run and jump and everything.
Wow, that was quite a jump. Have you ever tried the high jump?
What's the high jump?
It's a game to see who can jump the highest.
That sounds like fun.
There are lots of other fun things too, like running, throwing and... Oh, fiddly flower petals. What are they called? Oh, there's a special name for races and games and things. It's...
Brilliant!
Yes, it is. But that's not what I mean. It keeps you fit and healthy.
Hopping?
No, it's a word for all sorts of games, like running and football and cycling. Do you know what it is? Sport! That's it!
Fifi, Forget-Me-Not, forgot!
I know. Why don't we have our very own sports day?
With prizes for the winners! Yeah!
Prizes, eh? Oh, time to get fit! Slugs!
This bus?
Fifi's having a sports day and we're going to win!
What do I have to do?
Help me get fit.
Huh? Oh, what are you making, Fifi?
It's a high jump. We're having a sports day.
That sounds like fun.
That's it, boss. Push up and down. Keep going.
Slugsy, put a sock in it. I'm in trouble. We can do better than that, can't we, Slugsy? Especially after all our training.
It's your turn, Slugsy.
Come on, get on with it.
Never mind, Slugsy. Your turn, Stingo.
The jump, didn't I?
Yes, but you're supposed to jump over the pole, Stingo, not fly.
Spoil sport.
Stingo's disqualified, which means Pip wins the high jump.
Yay!
Ooh, it's time for our next game now. Hello, Aunt Tulip. Are you ready?
Oh, yes. Time for the tug of war. Girls, you can be on my side. Boys, you can be on the other.
The first team to pull the rope over onto their side are the winners.
With Slugsy on our side, we're bound to win. He's so heavy, they'll never budge him.
Go, Tots, go!
Get set, let's go. Everybody knows you can run.
What are you doing?
I'm putting them off. Come on, girls.
Once you try, you'll be flying. You're the star of the show.
Yay! We won!
Oh, rotten raspberries.
Oh, the sack race. This is my favourite.
What is it we have to do again?
On your marks, get set,
go, Tots, go!
Get set, let's go. Everybody knows. Okay. You can run fast, jump high, put on a show. Then get set, then go.
Ta-da! Oh.
Hurdle race. I'll definitely win this one.
If you say so, boss.
On your marks! Get set!
Go!
I don't think sports day's my thing.
Everyone's good at something, Slugsy.
Not me. I'm not good at anything.
OK, now the egg and spoon race. Careful you don't break the egg.
On your marks, get set, go, Tots, go!
I'm gonna...
Uh-oh.
Slugsy, wait till I get my hands on you. Come back here, you slimy slug. Slugsy!
Yay!
Let's do it again.
Why don't we do it without the eggs and spoons this time?
Yeah, you can start us off again, Aunt Tulip.
With pleasure.
Slugsy!
Uh-oh.
Get ready.
Go, Tots! Go!
Slugsy! You're a hero!
Slugsy!
Wow, Stingo! You are going so fast, you beat us all!
Huh? Did I? Bingo, Stingo! I won. Of course, I knew her word.
But it's Slugsy who should get all the praise. He caught me just before I was going to fall into that muddy puddle. Oh, Slugsy, thank you.
All the winners get a medal, but Slugsy should get the best. After all, he's the best sport.
It's not the winning that's important. It's having fun and being a good sport that really matters most.
Don't forget to come back soon.
Teach you, Stingo. Cheating always comes with a sting in its tail. Bum bum. My name's Kemi, and in a short while we'll be off to the softest garden in the whole world, where the softies come across a beautiful rainbow. After that, the bugs in Miss Spider's Sunny Patch Friends turn a frog into an insect. Speaking of which, it's time now for a caterpillar adventure. So here come the creepy crawlies. Oh, I'm feeling itchy just thinking about them. Oh!
Beyond the mountains and moors, through the forest and over the deep lakes, is an old castle, keeping a kindly watch over hundreds of tiny mini-beasts. These are the antics they get up to, and the tales they have to tell. It's midsummer. The heather is covered with pink flowers and caterpillars like Ellie. Ellie will change into a moth next year and fly away, but for now, she must be content to stay amongst the heather. The spiders live nearby on their sticky webs.
Oh, clumsy me. I think I've just broken your web. Sorry about that. I'm just off for a walk, see?
But the spider is too busy enjoying her breakfast and she doesn't notice. Ellie slowly makes her way down to the ground and out onto the moors. Nearby, the bumblebees are busy collecting nectar from the purple flowers. Ellie soon makes her way over to join the busy bees.
I do like these flowers. They're much prettier than the heather. Oh, if it's pretty sights you want, you should go to the lake. It's beautiful. Think I might go there myself, actually. Bye.
Ellie's never seen the lake, so she heads off to find it.
Ooh, well, I hope I'm going the right way.
You after the lake? It's Herbie the Hoverfly.
Come on, follow me. We're almost there.
And the two friends slowly make their way across the grass towards the water. Ellie wants to take a closer look at the ripples in the water.
Yeah, Ellie, love, this stone's a bit slippery.
Luckily, Ellie lands on a leaf. But then, a gust of wind blows her out into the lake.
Oh, no! What shall I do? I can't swim! Help! Help! Is anyone there? Help!
The dragonfly can't believe his eyes, but he doesn't realize that Ellie's in trouble.
A sailing caterpillar, whatever next. Good for you.
Poor Ellie's drifting further and further out into the lake. She passes the pond skaters having their breakfast on a lily pad.
Good job, there's plenty here for all of us.
Here, lads, I've just seen a floating caterpillar. Floating caterpillar? What are you talking about? Caterpillars don't float.
That's where he's wrong. Ellie's floating quickly away from the bank.
Help me! Help me!
This time, Herbie hears her cries.
Ellie! Use your feet! Try paddling!
So Ellie dips her front feet into the water and paddles hard.
Oh, it's cold. Oh, well, here we go. It's getting worse. I'm going the wrong way. That's it, Ellie. You're getting there. Keep going.
Ellie's exhausted, but a sudden gust of wind finally blows her back to shore.
Oh, hey, thank goodness for that. What a relief to be back.
I think you'd better stay well away from the water in future. But Herbie needn't worry. Ellie won't be wandering down to the lake again. She's off home to the heather bushes.
Mama, mama, me, 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 more milkshake.
Good morning, sunshine. Good morning, day. Good morning, softies, come out and play. Comfy, cozy, and cuddle too. Say good morning to you.
looks like it's been raining.
Yes, everything is wet.
Oh, the sun should soak up the rain and the garden will be dry again. Wake up, Cuddle. It's time to get up.
Oh, but I don't like the rain.
It's not raining now, silly. Look, the sun is out.
Oh, look at all the puddles.
Puddle. Puddle rhymes with cuddle.
Oh, look there.
Yes. What is it?
Look, in that puddle. It's got the most beautiful thing in it.
Ooh. Oh, Cuddle, you'll get wet. Besides, the puddle is reflecting the sky. Look up and you'll see why. A rainbow.
A rainbow! Isn't it lovely?
So many colours.
Why didn't we see a rainbow yesterday, Comfy?
Well, rainbows are very special. They only appear when it rains and the sun shines at the same time.
Ooh. It looks like rain again.
Oh, quick, up the garden path.
To the potting shed.
Hard hats on.
Let's all go up the garden path to the potting shed. This way, that way, around the flower bed. Over, under, to the potting shed.
Oh, no!
What's the matter, Cuddle?
The rainbow is fading. Oh. Ooh! What have you got here?
Oh, I'm not sure. Food! Yummy!
No, stop, Cozy!
Yuck! This isn't food.
That's a crayon. You draw with them on this paper.
Oh, can we draw something?
Yeah, that would be real fun, wouldn't it?
Yes, but what shall we draw? I know, we could draw a... Oh, no.
Oh, look! The rainbow's coming back. We could draw that. Yeah.
Good idea, Cuddle. Oh, yes.
What a lovely rainbow, Comfy.
Oh, thank you. Oh, look, it's stopped raining. Let's go outside and look at the real rainbow.
Oh, can I take this with me?
I don't see why not, Cuddle.
Yippee!
Thank you, potting shed.
Don't worry, Cuddle. I'm sure you'll see another one soon.
Sooner than you think.
Oh, yes. Cozy's right. There's a rainbow very close to you, Cuddle.
What do you mean?
Look in your hand.
Oh, of course. Now I don't have to wait for the rain and the sun. I can look at my rainbow any time I want to.
Time to get comfy.
All cozy.
And cuddle up.
Goodbye.
Sleepy time. Ooh. Comfy, cozy, and cuddle too. Sleepy time. Ooh. The softies say goodbye to you. Mama, mama, meeny, meeny, more milkshake.
Whoa! Hey! Whoa!
tree, a family on wings and strings and floaty things. Coming home for hugs, be good to Bugs.
Happy be good to Bugs Day, Gus!
Same to you, Beatrice!
Where are my little bugs this morning? You're missing some awfully good playing weather.
Shh! Coming, Mum!
Okay, has everybody got our story straight?
Just remember, we have to keep Felix a secret.
It seems funny to have a secret friend.
Not when the friend is a frog.
Yeah.
Definitely.
I don't think other bugs in Sunny Patch would understand us being buddies with a bug eater.
Felix eats bugs?
Not Felix, but... other frogs do.
Oh! All right, let's get going. He's waiting for us in the meadow.
I bet you bugs are excited about the Be Good to Bugs Day fair this afternoon.
Yep, almost as excited as we are about going to the meadow to play with each other. Right, with each other, the fair and each other.
That's right.
Yep. Bye.
Bye.
Smooth wiggle.
Bounce? Huh? What's got into your brothers?
I don't know. Triple-decker raspberry ripple cake. Yum!
This cake is for the fair this afternoon.
Okay. I'll see you then, Mum. I'll see you too, cake. Bye-bye.
Okay, everybody. Ta-da!
I like it so far, dear.
I was hoping for a slightly bigger audience. Where'd everybody go?
I'm still here, and I'd love to hear your tune, Holly dear.
Say no more. Triple-decker raspberry ripple cake. Yum! Yum!
Oh, here we go again.
Where's Felix?
Maybe he forgot we were meeting.
Or maybe his parents found out and they're cross. I bet they only want Felix playing with other amphibians.
Amphibi what?
Amphibian. An animal that can live in the water or on the land.
Oh, you mean like toads and salamanders and frogs? Felix!
Yay!
I'm so happy. I can jump over the moon.
Careful, Felix, or you might.
So... do you want to play some more hide-and-seek?
I've got a better idea. How about playing Super Secret Fly Spies?
Good idea!
That's a great game! How do you play?
Well, first, we all pretend we're spies. I'm Agent 00 Spider.
And I am the beautiful Vitalia.
Felix, you can be Agent Amphibious.
Oh, goody! Now what?
Now we hide.
Due to the recent frog sightings, I'm pleased to announce that we have a new recruit. Private Pillbug, welcome to Sunny Patch's elite anti-frog squad.
Did you say frog? Oh. Frogs? I don't see any frogs.
You can't even see me with your glasses off.
Of course I can, Mr. Mantis.
That is Mr. Spiderus, sir. Now, shape up.
Oh.
We are Sunny Patch's last line of defense. And how, pray tell, do you plan to catch a frog with that contraption?
It's a butterfly net, sir. It's a real beauty, eh? A gift from an actual butterfly. I forget his name. We've been friends for ages.
I dare say that any frog you might encounter will eat your butterfly net first and then eat you.
Oh, it will.
Well, perhaps not you specifically because of your unbearable stench. Enough! Let's just go and find that frog!
Of course, Mr. Spiderus, sir!
Let's roll Frog Squad!
I'd rather walk if it's all the same to you, Mr. Spiderus. Super Secret Fly Spies is great fun, Squirt.
Shh! And that's Agent 00 Spider, remember, Agent Amphibious?
Oops.
Who are we pretending to hide from again?
Dr. Chicken and his horrible hench hens.
Right. I'm the spy in the sky.
Any sign of foul play, Agent Dragonheart?
Well, there's some sneaky-looking flowers and some pretty shady toadstools. And... spiderers!
Hey, Dragon, don't mess around like that. You know spiderers really hates frogs.
It's no joke. Spiderus really is heading this way.
We've got to hide Felix fast.
That's Agent Amphibious.
Game's over, Felix. Quick, follow us.
Let's go. Come on, let's hide.
Here are some more goodies for the treat table, Beatrice. Looks like this is going to be the best Be Good to Bugs Day ever.
And don't forget the talent show. Mind if I practice my new tune for you friendly folks?
Rock on, Holly!
Excuse me, every buggy. Room for one more dessert?
Come on!
Huh?
Mm.
Ooh, can I have some?
Save a piece of it!
I wonder where my little bugs are. I expected Bounce to be first in line for my cake.
What was that?
Hi, fellas. You seen any bugs lately?
No, it's just those spider bugs.
See you with the fire bugs.
See you.
Bye-bye.
What is the hold-up here? We're supposed to be finding frogs, not chatting with children.
Yes,
Mind
sir.
Mind your mistress.
I don't want to find a frog.
Looks like the coast is clear.
Sorry, hiding is hard work. I'm hungry.
I'm hungry too. When's the Be Good to Bugs Day fair? I want cake.
I want cake too.
Cake is yummy.
Yummy sounds good. But what is a Be Good to Bugs Day fair?
Be Good to Bugs Day is when bugs of all shapes and sizes get together to celebrate their bugginess.
Oh, I wish I could celebrate my bugginess.
If only you weren't such a big green frog.
Yes. Hey, what if Felix didn't look like a frog?
You mean, what if Felix looked like a bug?
A big green bug.
Yay! Very funny, Felix. Get it?
Great, perfect.
Wow. How do I look?
Terrific.
You look like a big green bug.
Yippee! Look at me. I'm a bug. I'm a bug. Hop, hop, hooray!
Felix, you don't want to ruin your costume.
And bugs don't go...
Oops, sorry.
And now for the finishing touch.
Wow!
Anti-frog squad, halt!
Oh!
I said halt, not fall down.
Oh,
dear, oh, dear, oh, dear. What a dreary development. It looks like rain. You do realise what that means, don't you, Frog Squad?
You bet we do, sir. The Be Good to Bugs Day fair could be rained off.
Right. We better skedaddle before all the goodies get gobbled up.
Halt, anti-froggers. Rain means water. And frogs love the stuff.
Oh, yeah.
So those bug eaters could be anywhere.
Oh, they're spiderous. Better hide Felix.
What for? I thought that's why we made him this disguise.
You can do this, Felix. Just follow us and act buggy.
No problem.
Enough. There'll be no deserting your post in the face of the enemy.
Oh, hi, Spiderus.
We're just going to the fair with
our cousin here from Greenville.
Your cousin is an awfully big bug.
Oh, well, you see, that's because Felix is an insectus humongous.
Greenville!
Very rare.
Well then, I have a little question I want to ask Felix. Would you be interested in joining my anti-frog squad? I could certainly use a big strapping bug like you.
Of course.
I beg your pardon?
Yes, he's just got a little frog in his throat.
Yeah.
Touch of the bug flu. Right.
Come on, Felix.
I'm dizzy.
Wow, that is one big bug.
You said it, Frankie.
Welcome back, milkshakers. I hope you're ready for a bit of exercise because it's time to milkshake shake. Let's have everybody at home on your feet, please, and ready to shake. Here comes the tune. Grown-ups joining in. Face the telly, hold up this hand, and you're going to shake it four times as if you've got a wet hand and you're shaking the water off. Are you ready to go? Good. Take it away now. Four right, four left. Four shakes, both hands together. Then you cross them in and out. Flap your elbows for four. Shoulder shimmy, forwards and backwards. Shake high twice, shake low twice, shake round your face and start all over again. From the beginning, for this hand, four shakes together, in, out, flap your elbows for four like a funky chicken, shoulder shimmy. Very good, shake high twice, shake low twice, around your smiley face, do the high low bit again, good. And the grand finale, big shake right and left with both hands, two claps, thumbs up and smile, well done everybody. Phew, I don't know about you, but I think I'm ready to watch some more programmes. Let's kick off by going to Tooley Town with Mechanic. Then Bottle Top Bill will teach us how to catch a whopping great big fish. And in Funky Valley, Dippy will take a giant leap over the moon. I've never seen a cow jump over the moon before, have you? I'm sure there's a rhyme about that.
Come on down to Tooley Town. You'd better make it quick. The garage is just opening. It's time for Mechanic. From an ancient penny farthing to a racing car that's sick. He's the man to get you moving. He's the Mega Mechanic.
Mechanic, 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 Nick, Nick.
The sun was shining and all was peaceful at Tooley Garage. Mecha Nick was quietly humming while he worked on Professor Aubrey Bolingbroke's favourite car. The professor was showing Em a book of pictures.
These are called collage pictures because they're made of bits and pieces.
Lucy, Em's mum, was busy typing in the office. And Austin, who owned the garage and looked after Em and Lucy, was snoring away. But the piece was not to last.
Oops. Oh, Spanner, you naughty dog. Professor, Spanner set the alarm off.
What's that? I can't hear you, dear boy. Spanner set the alarm off.
Get off, Spanner. There's a big hole in your exhaust pipe, Professor.
Oh, fiddle faddle.
I'm afraid you'll need a new one. We need a new exhaust pipe for the Professor's car, Austin!
Oh dear, we've run out and the parts people can't deliver one today. Their van's broken down.
Sorry, Professor.
Fiddle faddle, what time is it?
1:30.
Oh no, I have to open the Thule Science Exhibition at 2:00, so I've only got,
30 minutes. Don't worry, Professor. I'll take the truck and pick up your exhaust myself. You know what I always say? Where there's a wheel, there's a way.
Oof. Oh.
Professor! Are you all right?
Oh, I'm just a little tired.
Oh, my goodness, Professor Aubrey.
Oh, thank you. Oh. But the science exhaust edition, the exhibaust...
Don't worry. Nick's got everything under control.
Yes, don't worry, Professor. You just have a nice cup of tea while you wait. I'll go and get your new exhaust right now in my truck.
Oh, dear. Sorry, Nick.
What are you going to do now, Nick? Don't rush me. I'm thinking. No exhaust, no truck, no science exhibition.
Just as all seemed lost, rescue was at hand.
It's Moose! It's Moose!
Moose was Nick's best friend and always ready to help.
Oh, Moose! We've got an emergency! How can I help? The professor needs a new exhaust pipe. Him or the car?
The car, silly. And he's been hit by a tyre and he has to open the science exhibition, but the windscreen on Nick's truck is broken.
Whoa, no, slow down. Exhaust, tyre, windscreen, exhibition? Well, that's simple. How? Professor? Oh, my. Have you ever been through Thule on a motorbike before, Professor?
No.
You get to see the whole town. Look.
There's the cinema with seven screens, the skating rink where I've never been, some smallish shops, and I buy my jeans from that one. The bowling alley, the football ground, the studios of Thule Sound, the car park store, I'm often found in that one. There's the cattle market, old town hall, the law courts, pond and waterfall, the pizza place he'll often call and get one. Oh! The big store where they just sell toys, the school that's packed with girls and boys, it's break time so there's lots of noise, it's great fun!
Weren't we supposed to stop at the town hall? Oops! Thanks, Moose. Got to run.
The professor made it to the science exhibition right on time.
There's chalk that talks, there's a fork that walks, a dancing television. There's a pie with eyes and a tie that flies at the exhibition. There's a nose that glows, silly clothes for toes, welly boots with fish in. There's a king with wings and string that sings at the exhibition, which I now declare open!
In no time at all, Moose, Nick and the Professor were back at the garage, mission accomplished.
How was the exhibition, Professor?
Very musical. I'll soon fix this, Professor. No problem.
In next to no time, Nick had fixed the exhaust on the professor's car and the professor was ready to leave. But there was another problem.
Nick, dear old chap, it's this pedal. Every time I press it, this happens. Oh dear, it sounds like you're going to need a new clutch. We used the last one yesterday, Nick. But I've got to sing the official opening of Thule Art Exhibition at 4 o'clock.
It's all right, Professor. I know what the problem is, and it's easy to fix. Spanner, fix! It was just Spanner's toy rat.
Phew! Bye, everyone. Thanks a million.
And that's the end of the tale.
If your roller skates or minibus need mending, take your pick. But of all the men to help you, you'd do best with Mechanic. Mechanic, 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 Nick, Nick.
Mama, Mama, Mini, Mini, Mom, Milkshake.
Bottle Top Bill and his best friend Corky. Up on the hill,
the adventures of Bottle Top Bill
and his best friend Corky.
Bottle Top Bill.
I think we should go down to the river today, Bill.
Great idea, Corky.
Will we have an adventure, Bill?
You bet. Today's adventure is called The Big Fish.
How will we get to the river?
Watch.
That's a good idea. A mountain bike. Let's go, Bill. Are you sure you packed everything, Bill?
Too right, Corky. This'll be the best picnic ever.
And look, there's the perfect place to have it. Right near the water.
We've got some nice fresh bread.
And some cheese.
And fruit.
And the tastiest chocolate cake ever.
Mmm, that's a great looking cake, Corky.
With just the right amount of chocolate.
I can hardly wait.
I hope no wild animals want to steal our picnic.
Don't worry, Corky. There's no wild animals around here.
What was that?
The Whopper!
The what?
The big Whopper! And he's stolen our chocolate cake!
What are we going to do?
We're going to get it back, that's what. Come on, Corky. We've got work to do.
Why have we come here to the shed, Bill?
You'll see, Corky. We're going to catch the Whopper, that's what.
Why is he called the Whopper, Bill?
The Whopper is the biggest fish in the river, Corky. He's a legend.
He is.
Lots of people have tried to catch the Whopper, but no one's done it. Now, where's my fishing gear?
No one at all, Bill.
No one until now, Corky.
Does that mean you're going to catch him, Bill?
Spot on, Corky. I'm going to catch the Whopper. First, we need to find a good place to go fishing. I reckon this is the place, Corky.
Should we start fishing here, Bill?
The first thing we need to catch the Whopper is some bait.
What about an apple?
Good idea, Corky. The Whopper won't say no to a nice apple like that.
Bill, why do you want to catch the Whopper?
The Whopper's a legend, Corky. Whoever can catch him will be an even bigger legend. And that's going to be me.
Will you be a hero, Bill?
You bet, Corky. They'll tell stories about me catching the Whopper. They might even sing a song about me.
A song about you, Bill? I can't wait to hear that. Look at that butterfly, Bill.
I can't, Corky. I have to concentrate on fishing.
How long does fishing take, Bill?
The secret to fishing, Corky, is patience.
You mean you have to wait for the fish?
You've got it, Corky.
Will we have to wait long, Bill?
I hope not, Corky.
That's good, because it's a bit boring just sitting here.
You're right, Corky. What we need is a boat.
How about that boat, Bill?
She's a beauty, Corky. It looks perfect for catching the Whopper. Come on.
I'll row, Bill. You catch that Whopper.
This looks like a good spot, Corky.
Throw your line out, Bill. Where did the line go?
It's here somewhere. Whoa!
Bill, are you all right?
I think so.
What was that, Bill?
That was the Whopper, Corky.
There it goes. It's getting away.
After it, Corky.
What about here, Bill?
Good idea, Corky. This looks exactly the sort of place where the Whopper would hide.
You don't think the Whopper is too clever to be caught, Bill?
No way, Corky. No fish can outsmart me. Watch. We'll get him this time for sure. I've got a bite, Corky!
Is it the Whopper, Bill?
It's very big. I think it is the Whopper, Corky.
We won't sink, will we, Bill?
No chance, Corky. I've got him now.
I don't think that's the Whopper, Bill. Do you think catching the Whopper is too hard?
We can't give up now, Corky. We've only just started. This'll get him. You watch. Look, Corky, I've got another bite.
Do you think it's the Whopper this time?
We'll soon see. I think it's definitely the Whopper, Corky.
What do we do, Bill?
Hang on.
Bill, maybe you should let go.
No way, Corky. This Whopper won't beat me.
Where's he taking us?
I don't know, but wherever he goes, we'll follow all the way.
I really think you should let go, Bill.
Never, Corky!
Bill, he'll pull us over the waterfall.
What waterfall?
This waterfall.
Wow!
Bill! Wow! Oh, no. I hope Bill's all right.
Corky!
Up here, Bill!
Come on down, Corky!
Have you lost the Whopper, Bill?
He's gone, Corky!
Okay, I'm coming! I'm sorry you lost the Whopper, Bill.
He's a tricky customer, Corky, but I'm even trickier. This time, I'll use a banana to catch him.
Are you sure we shouldn't go home, Bill?
No fish is going to beat me, Corky.
I hope you're right. Here we go again.
Where's he taking us this time?
It looks like we're going down to the sea.
The sea?
Down to the pier where the big crane is. The one that lifts all the cargo onto the ships.
Why is he taking us down there?
I don't know, but I don't want to end up on a big ship. We might never get back home.
We'll be fine, Corky. Trust me.
Let go, Bill.
But I caught the Whopper.
No, you haven't. The Whopper's caught you. Oh, no. Look.
What is it?
We're heading straight for those ships. I can't look, Bill.
Whoa! Ah! Ah!
We're leaking, Bill.
Don't worry, Corky. The Whopper's tiring. He'll give up any second now.
Somebody should tell that to the Whopper.
Won't be long now.
I think we're sinking, Bill.
I've nearly got him, Corky.
Bill, we're sinking.
Oh, no.
Now what do we do?
Yell for help.
Help! Help!
Keep yelling, Corky. There must be someone somewhere who can help.
I don't think anyone will hear us, Bill.
The Junkasaur Islands near here. Maybe they'll hear us.
I don't think so.
Well, yell anyway.
Help!
Did you hear that, Jojo?
I did, Dad.
It sounds like Bill and Corky.
It is Bill and Corky.
Help! Help! Help!
What are they doing, Dad?
It looks like they're having fun, Jojo.
Help!
Corky!
He's taking us right down to the caves at the bottom of the ocean.
I hope he doesn't leave us there.
Are you sure they're having fun, Dad?
I think so.
It's the Whopper! And he's got Bill and Corky.
I hope they weren't silly enough to try to catch the Whopper.
It looks like the Whopper's caught them.
We're still sinking, Corky.
I know, Bill.
Can't you plug that hole any better? Good work, Corky.
What can we do, Bill?
Just hang on, Corky.
Bill and Corky are in trouble, Dad.
That Whopper's giving them a rough ride, all right.
Oh, we better help them. Right, Dad, let's go!
I hope we lose this Whopper soon.
Right, Bill, look!
Oh no, sharks!
Are you sure they're sharks?
I'm double sure they're sharks!
And they look really hungry.
We might need their dinner!
It's Jojo, Bill, and it's Dad.
Are we happy to see you?
Hang on!
Thanks. Just in time, too.
Doing a spot of fishing, Bill.
That's about the size of it, Mr. Junkasaur.
Any luck?
I caught the big Whopper.
You caught the Whopper?
Actually, I think the Whopper caught us. That's why we're in all this trouble.
That'd be right. Nobody catches the Whopper.
Look, Bill. There's our boat.
Well, what's left of it? We'll have to swim back, Corky.
Can't we give them a lift, Dad?
Sure thing, Jojo. We'll just clear up the mess first.
That's the most delicious boat I've ever eaten.
Hang on, Bill. Hang on, Corky.
Thanks a lot. Goodbye, Bill. Goodbye, Corky.
Time for us to have our picnic now, Bill.
Top idea, Corky. I'm so hungry after trying to catch that whopper.
I'm sorry you didn't catch the whopper, Bill.
He was too good for us, Corky.
But you know something? I don't think he should be caught, Bill.
Do you really think so?
He's smart.
True.
He's brave.
True.
And he never gives up.
Very true.
A fish like that should be free forever.
When you're right, Corky, you're right.
Buttercup Bill and his best friend Corky. See you again. Goodbye.
Dippy was having a lovely, sleepy day in Funky Valley. She was enjoying a very nice dream about grass pudding when, from nowhere, a book landed on top of her head. Dippy saw something quite wonderful. A picture of a cow jumping over the moon. Dippy had never seen anything like this before. In fact, she liked the picture so much, she wanted to try it.
Quack, quack, quack.
The only thing was... Dippy wasn't very good at jumping. What are you trying to do? Said Hoot. After she'd explained in great detail, Porker asked a question. Can you help us, he said. Yes. And right away, he told the animals what to do. And moments later, Hoot the Owl, who was very clever, had three plans to get Dippy over the moon. The first plan, said Hoot, is to use the trampoline for Dippy to bounce over the moon. Come on, Dippy. Now, begin bouncing, said Hoot. And so she did. Dippy bounced, and bounced, and had almost reached the moon when... Time for plan B, said Hoot. It was time to try the catapult. Step into the catapult, said Hoot. But Dippy was a little nervous. Go on, Dippy. It'll be fine. Don't worry. Now let go of the catapult, said Hoot. And so, finally, they tried the rocket. Begin the countdown, said Hoot. Five, four, three, two, one, blast off! Oh, dear. idea. Dippy forgot to get on the rocket. And so, once again, Dippy had failed to jump over the moon. Suddenly she felt very sad. So sad, in fact, that she started to cry. And Clara felt so sorry for Dippy, she began to cry too. Then Porker and Fleecy began crying. Then Hoot the Owl. And then something magical happened. The animals cried so much that their tears made a puddle on the ground. Then Dippy saw something in the puddle that made her stop crying. For in the puddle was the moon. So that was the day Dippy jumped over the moon.
Enjoying our DVD so far. Have you noticed that we've got lots of animal friends here at Milkshake? There's all the bugs in Miss Spider, Pepper and George Pig, and all those crazy animals on the farm in Funky Valley. Well, if you like animals, then these next few programs are just for you, because you can join Bob, Mo and Jackie in the bird bath, meet Meow and Mao, have some fun with Noodle the monkey, and sail the seven seas with Cracker the parrot. Animal-tastic.
Come away, come away.
We'll be first to the bird bath today. It's very still. What can you hear?
Bob, 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 robin. Bob, bob, bobbing along. Whee!
It's Bob Robin.
Bob, 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 robin, singing a thirsty song.
Thirsty, Bob?
Hello, Herbert. I certainly am. There's not enough wind to ruffle a wren's feather.
It is very still. My pond is like a mirror.
What has Bob seen?
Wow, another robin. I must tell Jackie.
Jackie is with Mo Sparrow at the bird feeder.
Jackie! Jackie!
That's Bob Robin.
Keep your feathers on, Bob. What's up?
Has someone stolen the bird bath?
Fresh nuts. Oh. Mm.
So you've just come for a feed then?
No, no, no. There's a new robin at the bird bath.
A new robin?
Looks just like me too.
This I must see.
Mo left Bob and Jackie eating the nuts while she went to find the new robin.
Cooey, Mr. Robin. Where are you? Cooey! Might as well have a drink now I'm here. Knock me over with a feather. It's a sparrow, not a robin. I'm going to tell Bob and Jackie.
So I said to Guy Magpie...
Jackie! Bob! There's another sparrow!
As well as another robin?
No sign of a robin. Are you sure you didn't see a sparrow?
No, definitely a robin.
Definitely a sparrow.
Robin!
Sparrow! Sparrow.
Robin!
Sparrow!
I'll go and look. Wait here.
Jackie went to see for herself. Is it a sparrow or a robin?
I can't see a robin or a sparrow. Still, now I'm here.
Jackie found herself beak to beak with another blackbird.
Well, I'll be baked in a pie. You're not a sparrow or a robin. You're a blackbird.
Jackie flew off to tell Bob and Mo.
I'm full.
Me too.
Mo, Bob, guess what?
What?
It's not a robin and it's not a sparrow. It's a blackbird.
A blackbird?
Fi-da-diddle-o-da-diddle-o-dee. He's got the same wings and pointed beak as me. I saw someone just like me in a mirror. And saw him again when the water was still in the river. And I never heard him speak. But he's got the same wings and pointy beak as me. Fi-da-diddle-o-da-diddle-o-dee. He's got the same wings and pointy beak as me. Fi-da-diddle-o-da-diddle-o-dee. He's got the same wings and pointy beak as me. I've seen him on a shiny balloon. I've seen him on a silver spoon. I saw him in the bottom of a water well. I hope he didn't fall in it. It was hard to tell. Fi-diddle-o-da-diddle-o-dee. He's got the same wings and pointy beak as me. Fi-diddle-o-da-diddle-o-dee. He's got the same wings and pointy beak as me.
Jackie, Mo and Bob went together to meet the new blackbird. Or was it a sparrow? Maybe a robin?
Told you, a blackbird.
Told you, a sparrow.
I was right all the time. It's a robin.
And a blackbird.
And a sparrow.
I'm going to tell Herbert.
Herbert Heron was fishing when Bob arrived.
Herbert! Herbert! Come quick!
Do be quiet, Bob. I'm trying to catch my supper.
There are three new birds at the bird bath.
Really? There's one old bird here who's rather peckish.
Two?
I beg your pardon?
Two old birds. Look!
Ha 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 ha!
What's so funny?
That's not another old bird. That's me.
You? But you're you.
And that's me too. It's my reflection.
Reflection?
Watch. Gone.
I'm not surprised. You pecked him.
Watch the water. When the water is still on a bright sunny day, you can see yourself in it. It's called a reflection.
Wow. Thanks, Herbert. I'll tell the others.
This new blackbird won't talk to me. Talk to the robin, Bob.
They've gone.
You've scared them off, Bob.
Just watch.
Bob, Mo and Jackie stared at the water, and as the water settled, the three birds reappeared.
They're back.
They've gone again.
They're not new birds. They're you two. When the water is still, look, you can see yourself in it.
Is that me? It is me.
It's called your reflection. Herbert told me.
Bob, Mo and Jackie joined their reflections in the bird bath. I wonder what will happen next time at the bird bath.
Goodbye, and what fun there's been. Time at the bird bath.
Mama, mama, me, 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 more milkshake.
It was a glorious spring morning, and as the sun rose high in the sky, Sid and Eric were hard at work. They were preparing a special surprise, because today was the king's birthday. Come along, Eric. We've got to get everything shipshape for the king's birthday surprise. What's my job, Sid? You blow up the balloons, and I'll get the ingredients for the cake. Shiver me timbers, Sid. It's going to take a lot of puff to blow up all those balloons. No slacking now, Eric. That's marvellous, Eric. Well done. Thanks, Sid. Oh, dear. Well, don't worry, Eric. We'll soon have them all blown up. OK, time to make a start on the king's birthday cake. Let's see. Flour. Sugar. Cherries. Chocolate sprinkles. Oh, dear. There aren't any chocolate sprinkles left. Eric, I've got to go to the shops for some chocolate sprinkles. Can you take the cake out of the oven when it's baked?
No problem, Sid.
Don't forget now.
You can rely on me, Sid.
Unfortunately, there were an awful lot of balloons, and it wasn't long before Eric was feeling rather sleepy.
Oh, shiver me timbers, this is hard work. I've been blowing up balloons all morning. I think I'll just rest my eyes for a moment.
Just for a few minutes.
Oh, no! The king's cake! Oh, no! What have I done?
The cake was ruined. It was as burnt as a very burnt birthday cake.
Oh, Sid worked really hard on the king's cake. Oh, dear! What am I going to do?
Oh!
Oh, I hope nobody notices.
Eric, that's marvellous. It's the best birthday cake I've ever seen. The thing is, Sid, it's not a cake. You're right, Eric. It's a masterpiece. All it needs is the finishing touch. Chocolate sprinkles. But, Sid, the thing is... I understand perfectly, Eric. This will be a great surprise for the king.
Oh... I think you might be right, Sid.
Happy birthday, Your Majesty!
Hey, what? Oh, thank you, Sid. Thank you, Eric. Oh, and a cream cake with chocolate sprinkles, too. Oh...
Devil?
Oh, Sid, how clever you are. An exploding cake. That's what I call a real birthday surprise.
Oh, so do I, Your Majesty.
Mama, me, more milkshake.
going?
To the moon.
The moon? Buses don't take you to the moon.
If I was a bus driver, I'd take people wherever they wanted to go.
Oh, Noodle, you've just given me a really good idea.
Is it an idea for a monkey bake?
Yes, it is. We're going to do some moving and a grooving. Get yourself ready for a day on the buses. We're going to learn the bus driver rock.
That sounds great. What do we do?
OK, well, make sure you've got plenty of space around you. And, Noodle, why don't you go and have a look in the dressing up box and I'll see what I can find and get the music ready.
Here goes.
Let's get this bus on the road.
Sure thing, Naomi.
Oh, before we go on the road, I'd better show you a few moves. Are you ready for this, Noodle?
Oh, let's go for it.
Come on then, bus drivers. Start off by holding onto your big steering wheel. And you're going to do a move that's called drive the bus, turning your steering wheel four times with a little hip bop each time. Like that. Then you're going to tip your hat to your passengers and change the gear on your bus with a little lunge forward and backwards. Do that again. Tip your hat and change the gear. Then you start again with the driving the bus. A one, a two, three, four. Then take your bus for a little drive round in a circle with eight runs like this. A one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Start again from the driving the bus for four. A three, four. Repeat the tip the hat and change gear twice. Tip your hat, change gear, drive the bus. For four, three, four, and this time you take your bus in a little drive in a circle the other way. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now we're ready to welcome our passengers on board. So pretend your arms are the doors of your bus and you're going to open them up just a little bit with a little sway from side to side. Open them up a bit more. Open them wide and say, come aboard my bus. And then you're going to beep your horn this way and this way. Do that again, this way and this way. Do that bit again, opening the doors a little bit more. Open them wide, say come aboard and beep your horn for four. Three, four. Then at the end you're just going to take your bus on a very long drive, round in a circle this way with eight runs, round in a circle the other way, drive all over the place and at the end put the brakes on your bus.
Oh, that was toot-tastic. I can't wait to be a bus driver.
Come on then, step aboard or wait inside. Just remember to enjoy the ride.
We're all ready to go here, Naomi.
OK, bus drivers, hold on to that steering wheel and drive the bus. For four. Very good. Tip your hat and change gear. Tip your hat, change the gear. Tip your hat, drive the bus. That's it, Noodle. Big long drive, round in a circle this way. Yay, drive the bus. That's it. Tip your hat and change the gear. Twice. Change the gear. Tip your hat. Change the gear. Drive the bus. Oh, you've got that bit, Noodle. Big long drive this way. Ready to open the doors for the passengers. A little bit more. Open them wide. Say, come aboard. Beep your horn. Oh, yes, Noodle. Open the doors a little bit more. Open them wide. Say, come aboard and beep your horn. That's it. Big long drive with your bus, round in a circle this way and the other way. Oh yes, are you ready to put the brakes on your bus, Noodle?
Oh yes.
Ready and stop!
Oh, that was toot-tastic. How did I do?
Yeah, not bad for your first drive, but I think we'll take the bus for one last ride.
Toot-toot!
Come on everybody, holding onto your steering wheels, drive the bus. For four. Tip your hat and change the gear. Do it again. Tip your hat, change the gear and drive the bus. You're doing well, everyone. Big drive in a circle. Oh, that's it, Noodle. Start again. Drive the bus. Oh, yes. Tip your hat and change the gear. Change gear. Tip your hat, change gear and drive the bus. You enjoying this, Noodle?
Oh, yes, I am.
Big long drive this way.
Ooh, which way? Oh, this way.
Open the doors a little bit more. Open them wide, say come aboard. Beep your horn. Are you being cheeky, Noodle?
Oh, yes.
Do it again. Open the doors a little bit more. Open them wide, say come aboard. Beep your horn. Now you're going to take your bus for a very long drive.
Oh, which way? This way?
No,
oh, this
follow
way.
Me, Noodle.
Oh, I've got a bit lost.
Oh, dear. Follow me, I'll take you home. Oh. But he's put the brakes on your bus.
Oh.
Stop!
That was great. What a good driver. I think you're ready to roll.
Come on, everyone. Oh. Step inside. Don't forget to enjoy the ride. Toot, toot. Ooh.
Where are we going, Noodle?
Next up, the moon.
See you next time for some more monkey makes.
Bye-bye. Hold on, Naomi.
Mama, mama, mini, mini, more milkshake.
Mew and Meow were busy playing by the water when they saw something very strange.
Oh!
Somebody was cutting down a tree. Mew and Meow ran away fast. Then a doorway opened in the side of the tree.
Okay. Ready?
Go and see what it is, said Meow. I always go, said Mew. This time, you go first. Meow went to take a closer look. There was certainly something inside the tree trunk. The door snapped shut on Meow. He didn't like that at all. Somebody started building a house out of the wooden tree trunk. It's your turn to look now, said Meow. Off you go. So, Mew went to have a look. I wonder who's building this house, she thought. But the owner of the house didn't want to be disturbed. Mew and Meow decided to watch from a distance. The house was soon looking very pretty.
Hello, Mouse.
Hello, said a voice. The house belonged to a beaver. My house is finished now. Would you like to come to tea? Asked the beaver. Oh, thank you, said Mew. That would be lovely, said Meow.
Oh, it's you again. There's only 3 programmes left, but never fear. Because it's a DVD, you can watch your favourite shows over and over again. One of my favourites, Harry and his bucket full of dinosaurs, is up first. You know, I've always wanted to be transported to another world, but I can't seem to find a bucket big enough to jump into. Oh well. Rhubarb and Custard will also be here. Then after that, you'll get to find out what Eb gets for her birthday present in Ebb and Flo. Which reminds me, I must remember to send Eb a birthday card. Now though, it's time for fun by the bucketful.
Stegosaurus, pterodactyl, tyrannosaurus rex. Stilinosaurus, apatosaurus, triceratops is next. Touring fancy, seal troy, pterodactyl, stegy, what a sight. It's Harry and his bucket full of dinosaurs. To get on board the magic ride, all we do is jump inside. With Harry and his bucket full of dinosaurs.
Shut up, Harry!
But I like mud.
I'm sure you do, Harry. But it's bath time. You wouldn't want to miss that.
Yes, I would. Baths are horrible, Nana, and they're full of soap. I hate getting soap in my eyes.
Well, that's because you don't have the right equipment.
You see, Harry? Soap-proof goggles. Then it's not just a bath, it's an undersea adventure.
And you won't make me shampoo my hair or scrub my fingernails?
Well, maybe just a little.
No, I'm never taking a bath again, Nana. I'm going to stay dirty forever.
Well, we'll see about that.
No! In trouble.
We must see if he's all right.
Oh, no, look! Harry's being chased by a sea monster!
Oh, that's not a sea monster, Steggy Stegosaurus. That's Nana!
And Harry's in the lead with Nana closing in fast. And there they go! They're looking good. Harry, quick! Behind the chair!
I've got you now, Harry. You'll come clean or else.
Oh, no. Nana's picked up on Harry's trail. Harry, look out!
So there you are.
No! Oh, Harry!
Oh! 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 What are you going to do now, Harry? There's no place left to hide.
Yes, there is. Dino World. I'll bet nobody ever takes a bath there.
Well, not unless it's a mud bath.
Mud baths?
Of course. Dinosaurs practically invented mud. When we were born, we all crawled out of a big batch of stinky goo.
Not goo. Primordial ooze.
I love ooze and goo.
Oh, Harry!
It's Nana!
Quick, into the bucket!
Ready, Harry?
Yes!
I'm going to be the dirtiest, muddiest, stinkiest boy who ever lived.
One, two, three!
Jump, Harry!
Dino World. Oh, Harry, you're in trouble now.
Which way to the goo?
Ooze. Primordial ooze. Over there on the other side of Pillow Mountain.
But
But you'd better prepare yourself. It's smellier than a goat in a garlic farm.
You better believe it, Harry. This here is one stinky pit.
Wow. Let's go!
Stuff.
Well, it's before your very eyes, Harry.
That's it?
Oh, you haven't seen the best part yet. Look!
Disgusting!
Hey, this isn't disgusting. We can get a lot dirtier and stinkier than this.
We can!
This is fun!
Hurry, everyone! Time to take a dip!
Show you how it's done. Oh no. Bet she can't do that.
Okay, let's go.
You mean there's more?
Of course there is. We haven't even begun to stink.
Oh, I never realized getting stinky was this much work.
In a smelly old tennis shoe. Now this is totally yucky.
To be precise, garlic, rotten eggs, sausage, and a hint of blue cheese dressing.
If you ask me, it's a recipe for disaster.
Oh, I don't think garlic sauce goes with jam donuts and baked beans.
I say, Harry, look. The river's turning to mud.
I wonder where we're headed now.
Oh, no! I see it down there! We're headed straight for Smelly Swamp!
Whoa! Smelly Swamp! Last one in is a rotten egg!
Oh, no, Harry! We can't go in there! Smelly Swamp is the worst place in Dino World! Not even a dinosaur wants to get that stinky!
But I have to go where no stinky kid has gone before! And I want all you to go with me! Okay, I suppose I'll go it alone. Smelly Swamp, here I come!
Harry? Where did you go?
Ah! It's a swamp monster!
No, silly! It's Harry!
I did it, everyone! I'm the dirtiest, stinkiest boy alive! Come on, Terrence! Race you to the other side!
No thanks, Harry. Maybe some other time.
What about you, Tori?
I'm allergic to swamp. Sorry, Harry. Must go.
Okay, then. I'll go with you.
No, that's okay. You know what, Harry? We'll catch up with you later.
Hey! Everyone!
We love you, Harry! But you're too stinky, even for us.
But who will I play with?
I'll play with you, Harry.
Who are you?
I am King of Smelly Swamp. I hope you are enjoying my little playground.
Oh, yes. It's really, really slimy, yes.
What's
that smell? Why, it's even more disgusting than me.
You mean, it's me?
Why, yes, it appears you have outstinked me. You, my stinky boy, are now the new king of Smelly Swamp.
I am?
Think of it. You can rule over the swamp and be as stinky as you like. No brushing, no cleaning, and before you know it, no teeth.
No teeth?
And just wait until your hair falls out. You'll never have to shampoo again.
Well, I've got to go. Goodbye! No hair? Tori, Patsy, everyone! I've got to go!
Well, Harry, where are you going?
No hair gets them every time.
You know what, Nana? I like baths.
Is that so?
Yes. It's really hard to make friends when you have stinky stuff growing between your toes. You know what I like best about being clean, Nana?
What's that?
Tomorrow I can get dirty and stinky all over again.
Oh, no. Not again. No.
You could say that it was more than just a hot day. You could even say that it was a real stinker. The birds were hanging out of the tree, and their tongues were hanging out of their beaks. Other than that, there wasn't a soul to be seen. The day was heading to be an absolute snorter. Even the sun found it hard going. There wasn't a cloud in the sky, not a skylark, nor a bee to be heard, not a cat on the fence. But there was a hot wind, there were hot sounds, and there was hot dust everywhere. Oh, whew, weird weather, panted Rhubarb when he eventually ventured out and found Custard, who was lying on the ground covered in a blanket of dust. Don't you think that blanket of dust is a bit thick for a hot day like today? Asked Rhubarb.
What?
Muttered Custard. I said, it's weird weather, whispered Rhubarb. And as Custard stood up, the dust swirled, and it was quite obvious that they had both heard it.
What was that?
Shouted Custard. Moggy's wind chimes, offered Rhubarb.
No, they go off all the time.
You're right, said Rhubarb, and there it was again. Oh, dearie me, what can it be? They begged each other in the heat of the moment. And when it happened again, they both jumped into each other's arms and fell to the ground in a heap of dust. When the dust had cleared, Rhubarb and Custard sat up and looked around. The birds were hanging out of the tree, their tongues were hanging out of their beaks, the sun was sweltering, the heat was horrible, the noise was closer, the chums were terrified. What could it be? Rhubarb squeaked. Custard couldn't talk, but he could point. So he pointed very quietly. Two tall for a snail's pace, but quite unhurried, what looked like an exotic shed was moving along the lane on the other side of Rhubarb's fence. And then, of course, there was the scary noise.
Hello, now. No need for your computer to tell what that is,
Custard finally managed to say. Well, what is it? Rhubarb was eager to learn.
It's mysterious. That's what that is. Mysterious,
said Custard, and stood up and dusted himself down. After convincing Rhubarb that they should find out what the mystery was, Custard held the ladder while Rhubarb peeped over the fence. Oh, it's nothing, said Rhubarb with a sigh of relief.
What do you mean, nothing?
Custard boiled in the heat. Well, it's not dangerous, said Rhubarb.
Well, if it's not dangerous, invite it in,
Custard steamed. There was a great kerfuffle in the tree as Rhubarb opened the garden gate, and after knocking down both gateposts, the exotic shed lumbered into the garden, perched on top of an elephant. The noise! It's the noise! Shouted Rhubarb in an overheated, overexcited kind of way, and Custard nodded.
The noise,
he sighed. How do? Said the elephant. Eric! Rhubarb, said Rhubarb, and introduced Custard. And Custard. That's a very nasty noise you have, Rhubarb shuffled. Aye, you're eat there, lad, snuffled the elephant.
Do you speak English?
Inquired Custard. And the elephant sneezed.
Ah!
He's a right one-year dog, ain't he?
Bellowed the beast and pushed Custard in a friendly kind of way that sent him reeling across the garden.
I were a pit elephant, worked in a coal mine, umping coal, till I got tut sneezes. I'll ne'er forget that day, explained Eric.
I see, said Rhubarb. And what about the, he shrugged and pointed at the exotic shed.
Oh, me grandad were a prince, you see. And that was his coal shed,
came the explanation, followed by a sniff.
Oh, I say, it's a bit hot, ain't it? Don't suppose you've got a cup of tea, have you?
Gasped Eric, and hooted feathers all over the garden. Well, as it is so very hot, wouldn't perhaps a pond be better than a cup of tea? Rhubarb suggested. And before you could say, e by gum, Eric had all but slurped the goldfish out of house and home.
Well, lads, you done me grand. And if you ever up my way, don't be behind in coming forward. I'll be off then,
sniffed Eric, and turned towards what was left of the garden gate, just as Mouse turned up. In a flash, Eric had leapt up onto a garden chair, and the noise he made shook the very ground. What followed was a thunderous sneeze, followed by monsoon rains that doused the dust, cooled the air, soaked the garden, and even filled the empty pond. Rhubarb just stood. Custard just stood. They just stood and stared at each other. Then, at Mouse.
What did I do?
Squeaked Mouse.
Eric is an elephant, said Custard.
And you are a mouse. Mouse, said Rhubarb.
This way, where the silver boats come and go, you know, you can always
Let's find ebb and flow. Ebb loved playing with her squeaky ball. It was her favorite toy. Ready? Fetch! What's the matter, Ebb? The ball had lost its squeak. Cheer up. It's your birthday tomorrow. You're coming to Ebb's party, aren't you, Bird? Good. There's going to be lots of food and games and presents. Flo was helping to make Ebb's birthday cake. I'm going to put chocolate buttons on the top. But Ebb was worried about her ball. She wanted Flo to make it squeak again. Flo and Bird were off to the shops. Sorry, Ebb. You've got to stay or it won't be a surprise. Into bed, please, Flo. You too, Ebb. It's your big day tomorrow. But Ebb didn't really understand. All she wanted was a squeaky ball. It was the perfect day for a birthday party. Everything was ready. Happy birthday! Go on, Ebb, blow! There was plenty of food for everyone. You don't have to eat it all at once. Party games. Stay, Ebb. I'm ready. It's your turn to hide. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Shh. Ebb waited and waited. Why didn't Flo find her? Ebb had never seen a flying doggy chew before. Happy birthday, dear Ebb. Should I help you unwrap it? Ebb decided she liked birthdays and food and games and presents. But most of all, she liked being with Flo. Things couldn't be better.
That's all from us, I'm afraid.
We hope you've enjoyed watching the programmes as much as we've enjoyed choosing them for you.
Yeah, and I think we all deserve a pat on the back.
Oh, yes.
And you deserve a pat on the back for your fabulous milkshake shaking.
And for being such dedicated milkshakers.
Keep shaking.
See you soon.
Bye.
Bye-bye.